I will briefly present three cases today, three use cases, one from bachelor studies and two other from the master studies. And I would like to thank my colleagues from Vytautas Magnus University, Faculty of Humanities, Jurgita Vaičenonienė and Loik Bozou, for provided information for this presentation. And for the first use case, it is a course Lexicology and Lexicography of Lithuanian Language, given in BA study program Lithuanian Linguistics and Publishing. And part of the course, I'm a teacher in this course, and part of the course is also Clarin content. What we do with students during hands-on sessions, for example, if we have to deal with the question, what is the nature of content and function words, then we use lemmatized word lists, or if we want to know what are the challenges of automatic multi-words expression identification, then the students have a possibility to experiment with the Colloq. It is a tool for automatic identification of multi-word expressions. And a significant part of my course is the project work, where students actually have to work in groups on a dictionary project. And of course, depending on the topics, they access and reuse available resources in Clarin LT repository, or I have a possibility to discuss with the students how to collect a new corpus or new data. To give some examples how these students' projects, dictionary projects, look like. So if it is compound idioms, then they use word lists or lemmatized word lists to search for these idioms, yes, for these compounds. And if it is a project about the new formations with the euro, then they make a search in the corpus of the contemporary Lithuanian language. And going to the next courses, to the master courses. In the study program Applied English Linguistics, the course Contrastive English-Lithuanian Stylistics is given, and part of the course is also devoted to the Clarin content. Then we see that during the lectures, the basics of research infrastructure or of research data management are discussed, and the Virtual Language Observatory platform is introduced. And then the students have a possibility for in their hands-on exercises just to analyze or to find the translation relevant resources from English and other languages. Of course, there are a lot of case studies, a big area for case studies, and the main questions are to develop awareness of the features of translated Lithuanian. And here the lecturer uses Clarin LT resource Orvalit, morphologically annotated multilingual corpus. And it is actually used only in the class, but it will be available in Clarin LT repository soon. In the next slide, I would like to present the last course. It is natural language processing given in MA program Modern Linguistics. And mainly in the lectures, but also in the hands-on exercises, the students could try not only Clarin LT, but other Clarin resources. For example, if they are studying automatic annotation, then a good example is how the annotation of the Lithuanian text could be made, morphologically or syntactically, are these two corpora that are available in Clarin LT. Matas and Tree Bank Alksnis. And also the students, they have to try to use a tools from, for example, UDPipe or HFST from the Clarin Knowledge Center, Safmoril. Sometimes, as the lecturer says, it is a challenge for linguistic students. It was mentioned also by Amalia, but still it is very useful. And if I could sum up, then I would name some key advantages, because I think the use of publicly available licensed language resources is actually a good possibility for students to use ready language data and NLP tools and to get understanding about sharing practice in scientific research, about ethical and legal issues. For example, if they see the labels publicly available or academic use, they can understand them. And it is important, of course, especially for MA level students, even if they have an information theoretically, yes, during the lectures about the research infrastructures or the stages of data management plans, it's still important for the future research, yes, to make some practical experience then later. Yes, the lecturer, they say it is no extra time for Clarin content, but the solutions we use, we use Clarin content as a part of the course. Students could use Clarin tools and resources when they write seminars, works, BA thesis or MA thesis. And thinking about our future plans, we hope for better integration of Clarin content in the practical part of the course, especially in this linguistic courses, because natural language processing course, they have this part, this practical part, very good, in this practical part, they have very good integration of all these NLP tools and resources. So thank you for the invitation, and that's all.